I'm Andrew Edwards and you're watching Gear Live. Today I need to take a trip to Portland. I live in the Seattle area, actually above Seattle, and it's gonna be the first day that I take the Tesla Model 3 out for a long road trip, and it just so happens to be happening in the snow. So we're gonna see how the battery holds up in the snow, how the car holds up in the snow. Get inside so I'm not freezing, and ultimately how the Tesla Model 3 handles in cold weather. Let's go.
All right, let's see what it looks like getting to the Moda Center today. So here we go. So it should take me about 3.5 hours to get there. 2:26 arrival time. I'm not sure that's gonna be accurate due to the traffic that we're gonna be seeing with all the snow, and plus you're just driving slower in the snow as well. We are likely gonna have to stop to charge somewhere. Battery will deplete faster in the freezing temperatures. Autopilot isn't even showing as an option right now, and that's because, as you can see the roads here, autopilot can't see the lines in the street. There's no way to guide the car between the lines when you can't see where the lines even are. I'm hoping the freeway is easier to drive on than this, because the compacted ice and snow on the road just means you have to go super slow to be safe. Look at this man waiting for me out in the snow. Look at this dude.
Moment of truth. It's the moment of truth.
This dude almost slipped, bro. Bro, you almost slipped.
I pulled the Air Force Ones, bro.
We need to.
Let me see if I can figure this out.
Can you even open that door? Oh no.
Oh my God.
All right, we're out here trying to let him get in the car. And this thing is, oh!
Got it.
There it is. There it is. All right, the snow, man. The roads are frozen. There was just a car facing this way.
I mean, literally.
On the freeway, facing us on our side. Look, we're on our way to the Centralia Supercharger right now.
Yes.
It says it's 89 miles away, and we have, according to the car, 262 miles. However, I'm making the assumption right now that the battery is gonna drain faster than what it says based on the weather. So I don't think we really have 262 miles in us. So we're gonna hit the supercharger, charge up on the way. But let's see, Malik did the math. We should arrive at the supercharger with 174 miles if this is accurate. My guess is that it will not be 174, it'll be less, because the battery is probably not liking these freezing temperatures. It's 27 degrees, come on. Look at the window, bro, I'm not happy. Like, I heard people complain about the lack of heated windshield wipers, right? And I was like, why would you need heated windshield wipers? That's a weird thing to complain about. Now today, look at this. The windshield wipers are just full of ice and snow.
Yeah.
And now I wish I had them. And we're going to a gas station so that we can squeegee off the window. Labor. Clean the window. The first squeegee I tried was completely frozen, and I almost fell. I almost fell. Straight up icicles. Icicles on the vehicle.
This man just bought gloves because he's cold. Did he think that like these work gardening gloves?
Look at this. Look at this. Who buys that at a gas station, bro?
Come on, bro.
This guy. What are you doing?
Hey, man. You know
what are you doing?
It's that Timberland weather, man.
We're headed to the Centralia Supercharger right now. 240 miles left. Maybe. Apparently.
Yeah.
We'll see. When we get there, we'll see if it's a 174. 174 or above. All right. Autopilot is engaged for now. We'll see what happens. A whole bunch of snow on our windshield. We couldn't even see. The car's like, I can't see either.
What?
Just pulled into the first supercharger And this is interesting. So I knew the battery would not last as long as Tesla said it would. So check this out. As you can see, 121 miles is what they say is left on the battery. That battery should actually say 174 miles based on the estimation that it gave us earlier. So we should have arrived here at the supercharger with 174 miles left on the battery. It's only at 121, which means it was over 50 miles off. So I'm glad we stopped here at the supercharger to get some juice. So we're gonna plug in, get some juice, get some food, and then head down to Portland. Just plugged in, and as you can see, we're charging at 330 roughly miles an hour. So in an hour, we should be pretty much full. In fact, an hour and 10 minutes, we'll have a full battery. This is way faster than the charger I have at home, which charges at about 43 miles an hour. So that's fantastic. All right, just had lunch, all charged up, heading down to Portland. We got another 90 miles to go to hit Portland. So let's see how we fare, because once again, I'm assuming we're not gonna get all the range that the Tesla is estimating we're gonna get. All right, it says we have 268 miles charged up, which means we should have about 178 miles when we arrive, since we have 90 miles to go. I'm gonna assume it's gonna be more like 130 miles left when we arrive. I-5, what's happening?
How much of it is?
Why is the car getting mad?
Vancouver, Portland, on the way.
Thank you.
Receive goes in the
dash.
Okay.
Thank you.
Now we are finally parked. We've made it to the destination. Let's check how good the Tesla was at estimating. As you can see right here, it says we have 140 miles left on the charge. Now, when we left, we had 268, and it said it was 90 miles away. So we should have been left with 178 miles, which means 38 miles it was off by. 38 miles. So don't trust it outright, especially in that cold weather.
What you grabbing out of there, man? Oh, 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 man. Oh, oh, oh.
The heck? Jeez. What? This is terrible.
Uh-huh. Hold up.
On the way back, stopping at another supercharger. I want to be safe. It says we have about 120 miles that we can drive, but as we've seen throughout the day, it's not that accurate, and I don't think we'll have enough juice to get to the next supercharger on the route. So we stopped a little earlier. Supercharger's right here, and we're gonna charge up. One thing I don't like about this one though, this sign right here, 60 minute general parking. So you can come here and charge your Tesla, but anybody, Tesla or not, can also park here for an hour. So you might be trying to get home and you show up here, and if it's an active time like Christmas, for example, it might be filled up and you can't juice up and get home. Come on, it's snowing again. Got about three hours and 15 minutes to get home after we charge, and it's snowing again, and we also might need to charge one more time. We'll see how it goes. All right, I've charged up to 187 miles worth of charge. The next supercharger is about 77 miles away, so in theory we should have 110 miles when we get there. I'm assuming no, that will not be the case. Maybe we'll have around 80. We're gonna stop there, charge up while we eat, and then that should be good enough to get home. All right, made it to the next supercharger. We were supposed to have, I believe, 110 miles left. We do not have that. Instead, we have 62 miles left, according to the Tesla estimated range. So it's a good thing we did stop at that first supercharger. Now, we're gonna plug in here, try to get a full charge, grab some dinner. It's about 10:30, hopefully there's something open.
We just charged for about 37 minutes, and if we pull up the charge screen, we'll see that we gained 193 miles in that 30-minute time frame. If we want to go to 100%, we got another 30 minutes to go. Give it a few more minutes to get a comfortable amount of charge so we can make it all the way back to the Seattle area.
All done with what I hope is the final supercharging event of the night. We have 279 estimated miles. And again, I'm just using estimated miles to see how accurate it is. As we've seen today, not that accurate. 102 miles to go. So hopefully having almost triple the amount of miles needed or estimated miles needed, we can get back. So it's about 11:20 p.m. Let's get out of here and go home. We just ended the trip. It's about 1:40 a.m. We got back with about 118 miles estimated on the Tesla Model 3. So made it home, did not need to charge again. So there you have it. That is cold weather in the Tesla Model 3. We're driving right now. It's about 18 degrees out here, so it's pretty cold. If you're driving in cold weather, you do have to watch out for that range. It will deplete faster than the Tesla expects it to. So make sure you stop at the superchargers and charge up appropriately.